Hello and welcome back for race two of round two's races at Birmingham Motorplex. That wasn't a very good choice of words, sir. We're just ending qualifying and it looks like Matt Farrow is going to be on pole again. He has just pipped Mr. Ruskus. Third will be Andreas Eriksson, Jordan Weeks will be fourth, Richard Sobolewski is fifth, Anders Nilsson is sixth, Mark Foley seventh, Tim Brooke, good performance considering he's only done one race as practice in this car, he's in eighth, Gary Lennon ninth, poor performance from him there, Stenback also a bit slow there in tenth, Sergio Sousa is 11th, Mohamed Patel 12th, also struggling, Dave Simmons in 13th, Bradley Vanian is in 14th, Mario Moraes is 15th, Wayne Reed is in 16th, Floria Callan is 17th. Looks like someone has just jumped up the standings there, I didn't see who that was, as qualifying looks like it is over. I could use this now as an opportunity to let you all know that in around May 2012 we will be starting off a Team Endurance Challenge. Seven rounds, as you can see, around some of the most challenging circuits in Le Mans racing. A nice mix there, a few American tracks there, races between 6 and 12 hours long, three classes, 44 teams, using a variation of the Endurations mod. Private for SRO, so head over to the forum, have a read, sign up will be next week, and yeah, it's going to be a great championship. Looks like we have moved to the warm-up, and Matt Farrow did get pole, so just to confirm, Farrow and pole, Ruskus is in second, Eriksson in third, Jordan Weeks fourth, Sobolewski fifth, Nilsson sixth, Patel in seventh, so last minute improvement for him there, Foley eighth, Brooke is in 9th, Gary Lennon down in 10th, going to need to recover from that poor qualifying performance, Stenbeck in 11th, Sergio Sousa is in 12th, 13th is Dave Simmons, 14th Bradley Vanian, Mario Moraes in 15th, Wayne Reed 16th, Floria Callan in 17th, so will it be the same again in race 2 as race 1, Farrow on pole, and he do what Eriksson did for the first round and take the first two wins. That will mean if he wins this race, he will start from 10th on the grid in race 2. No, sorry, race 3, as it's a reverse top 10 for that one. So, obviously, a couple of the guys around 11th, 12th, and 13th will all be fighting hard to get 10th in this race in the pole position for race 3. Just 1:50 to go. We can go live to the track now as we see a few people doing donuts to settle the nerves for the race. Well known tip for you there. Tip of the day for Mr. Nilsson. Haven't had that one for a while, so. Just want to explain now that it feels a bit strange commentating on this by myself. Normally I prefer the second man role of finding the action and coming in with a few points, but also I'm sitting here and I can't actually hear the cars. So whenever I try and get excited, not that I'm a very enthusiastic, exciting commentator, but it also feels strange that when I try and do get a bit excited, I am sitting in silence and feel very alone. So. Apologies if it sounds a bit strange at certain times. Hopefully I will have a partner or be able to race at the next round. I did enjoy these at Alton Park. Really fun cars to drive. Yeah, I am hoping to be back in the car for round three, of which the track I cannot remember, so apologies for that. So, 25 seconds to go. Drivers will be doing their last minute preparations, probably putting around between 15 and 20 litres in the car. These don't use much fuel at all, so no real advantage to trying to go tight on the fuel, because you will be a mug if you run out on the last lap. So better to be safe than sorry. as it really does make little or no difference taking an extra 2 or 3 liters. I think most of the drivers at the top will be running with the extra camber add-on, which seems to help a bit to the corners, makes it a bit more stable. I think provides a bit more grip, but I'm not sure if everyone will be running with that. I haven't had it confirmed 100% if it is faster, but I believe it to be faster, so I'm sure there will be quite a few running with it. So the clock is down to zero in warm-up, so we will be going live to the grid any moment now, and it looks like we have. So we are with Farrow. Wait for him to jump on the grid. But Ruskus is raring to go. This is the first one on the grid. Let's see if we can get a still camera shot here. There we go, I've managed to pause it there. But we should get a good view of the start line action. Yes, you can see the qualifying times up there. Now 18 drivers in this race, so pretty decent grid. And there we go, we get the lights. And we're green, it looks like a poor start by Farrow. Everyone looks like they've got away okay. As we look at Ruskus, who seemed to get an initial good jump, but now he's under pressure, second place from Ericsson. So somewhere in the second phase of the start, Farrow maybe braked a bit later and went defensive on the inside. Well, I was expecting Ruskus to really be at least alongside, if not leading, going through turn one with the start he got. But that is not the case, so what will be important here is how fast or how quickly Ericsson can get past Ruskus. He didn't manage to do it last time until the last lap, but actually cost him, as he was a real loser. We got a spinner there, I believe that was, looked like that was Anders Nilsson. So let's see if we can get a replay of what just happened there. I'm actually quite sure who this is. Looks like they go down to Dunmore, right on board with Tim Brook. Now, looks like there's contact up ahead. Let's see if we can find out who that was. It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to find it with the cameras. Oh, there we are. Yep, so that was Nielsen. We watched the replay here. Looks like he ran out wide, and then Foley had nowhere to go and contact it with him. So Nielsen all the way down to 16th, looking up the inside of Mottram. Into turn one, thinks better of it. Let's jump back to the front. Farrow leads. Ruskus on the tail. Ericsson dropped back somewhere, so not a good start by Ericsson. Really needs to be putting under pressure and get onto the back of Farrow if he wants any chance with this championship, because so far there's been a perfect night for Farrow. Two pole positions, race one win, and looking odds on favourite to get another win. Ruskus found some extra speed in qualifying. It was so close. Farrow. So let's see if Ruskus can be the man to take the charge to Farrow. So Ericsson third. Fourth place is Jordan Weeks. Good start from him. Fifth place is Tim Brook, who's going out wide sideways. He's going to be three of them as he's going. Contact there with Stenbeck. Stenbeck's going to get the cut back, but will he have momentum to charge down into turn one? He's thinking of it. And who's that behind him? That's Foley going side by side with Lennon, I believe. It's a good start by Lennon. And Stenbeck all over the curbs up on two wheels. He's going to get mugged. It looks like Foley's going to try and go down the inside. Thinks better of it. Gary Lennon going for the outside. Definitely going to take Foley here. This is a dangerous point as they try and go side by side here. Definitely some contact, and that's Lennon off. That looked pretty inevitable. That seemed a very, very strange place to try and go side by side. As we watch the replay now, looks like the overlap, the outside line, and yet cut down into space where he really shouldn't have. Maybe he was already out of control before the contact with Foley, but that sent him all the way down the pecking order. And who's that spinning back there? I don't believe I saw who that was. So action going on all over the grid as we watch here. And Stenbeck is now in sixth. Brook is up to fifth as Ericsson sets the fastest lap. It was Farrow, but taken away by Ericsson straight away. So excellent form here from Brook, who has spent no time in the car. We saw him join the server for the very first time in race one, in warm-up, with seconds to spare. Fourth is Weeks, who's all by himself, and then Ericsson is in third, Ruskus in second. Top three a little bit spaced out at the moment, so taking it easy. Safaro still leads. Let's go a bit further back. There's Foley in seventh. Wayne Reed, similar to race one early on, gets up to eighth. That is going to be Sousa in ninth with Atlantic Racing Team. 10th is Sobolewski. Not a good start for Hemingway 11 in 11th, obviously with those issues with the spin running out wide there. 12th is Jonathan Motteram. Looks like he has got I think that is Bradley Vanian behind him, and who's that going sideways? I didn't see who that was. It's not Nilsson. It's Dave Simmons as he waits, and does a good job there of not getting in the way. So Nilsson is up to 13th as he pairs. Who's that behind him? That is Patel. Is Patel another shocker of a start then? He's in 14th. Let's get the standings up for you, because I think that was all a bit muddled up, me trying to communicate that there to you. Let's see if we can get a shot of all the cars coming through. So we are, looks like Ericsson is putting Ruskus under pressure. That's not going to be good for anyone that wants to challenge Stefaro for the win today. You see, we've only been racing for 6 minutes and the car's already spread out, but here we've got a nice sequence of cars all pretty close. So I think that's back for the battle for sixth place, I believe. Yes, it is. Matt Farris has the fastest lap there. So Foley is in sixth, I believe. He has got a train behind him. Seventh is Timbrook. So Timbrook has made a mistake somewhere, because we were just praising him for being up in fifth. It's all happening a bit too quickly for me today. I'm getting too old to keep up with the action. Looks like Wayne Reed is in 8th position, yep, so Sergio Sousa is 9th, it looks like. Is that Dobolewski with his headlights on? It's not very dark on track, so I don't know if this is an attempt to unsettle Sousa. It looks like he's worked, because Sousa's gone deep into the corner, takes a lot of curb, just about holds onto it, but that's going to allow Sobolewski past, and the headlights go off from Sobolewski, so obviously in a rush to get the job done. So Sousa down to 10th, Gary Lennon recovering in 11th after a promising start. 12th is Nilsson, who we also saw spinning on the opening laps. 13th is Motteram. 14th is Mario Moraes, Atlantic Racing as well. Dave Simmons in 15th. And 16th is Bradley Vanian, who is a DNF. And I believe we're also going to have another DNF here of Mohamed Patel. I don't know what happened there. We've missed that one. And we are the number 18 car. So, and 19 looks like that could be a DQ for Floria Callan. So don't really know how that has happened. So, yeah, Matt Farrow leads. Once again, pretty much a replay of round race one, sorry, tonight. Second place is Mr. Ruskus, who seems to be driving tonight, looking in his mirrors, robbed of second place with seconds to spare in race one. Will he make the same mistake this time? Ericsson obviously wanting to keep his championship charge on the move, but losing out to Farrow like that in the first race, we'll probably just see a shift of power in the stands. I think Farrow should be leading by one or two points after that result in race one. Obviously quite a few places between them. In fifth, Stenbeck all by himself, so it's pretty quiet at the moment out on track. We've got another 6.5 minutes to go. Sixth is Foley, so here comes the train of cars being headed by Wayne Reed. So we've got Wayne Reed seventh, and Timbrook behind him. And is that going to be Gary Lennon? Yep, so Gary Lennon's got up to ninth, so he's made a couple of places up since we last saw him, so would expect him. He's probably the quickest driver out of these three here. But will he be able to make a pass? We've got any mistakes in this race to see if Forslath Brook in front of him spinning. I think he's hit the wall, and it's definitely some contact there as he got loose. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. Right on board with him, up to the far chicane, second part, right hander takes a bit too much curve, loses the back end, and yeah, definitely hits the wall. Slide on a bit there, so it's not going to be too bad in damage, but obviously a load of places lost there for Brooke. That puts Lennon up to 8th. Here we are as we look back on Gary Lennon's car. This is Riley on board with Wayne Reid, battle for 7th. That puts Nilsson up in 10th and Sobolewski in 11th, so maybe Sobolewski made a mistake that's given the other guys a few mistakes. We saw Sobolewski passing Sousa early on, so something has happened to Sobolewski, so pretty much a night to forget so far for Richard Sobolewski, struggling to find the form that he used to have on R-Factor. Obviously very much an iRacing man at the moment, but does enjoy coming back and racing some of the fun mods on R-Factor. It looks like Ruskus has eked out a bit of breathing space in the battle for second. I believe that is around 3 seconds behind the leader, Farrow, who heads about halfway through the lap, 4 minutes to go, so 3 to 4 more laps of this race. Obviously the reverse grid, so he's going to be on 10 for race 3. If it continues as it is. So who is in 10th at the moment for the battle for 10th? It's Nilsson. Sobolewski with his headlights on again, putting him under pressure. These two arch rivals on and off the track, having a mini championship themselves. Let's see who can beat the other one. I believe Sobolewski is winning after round 1 at Alton Park. He will be trying his hardest to get 10th spot. He knows that is the reverse grid, so everyone up front, they make a mistake, it makes this easy, but if everyone stays where they are in front of them, it will be a very exciting finish. And I know Sobolewski will be trying any potential move, even if it's not gonna have any chance of paying off. He'll be making that move to get 10th spot. So I feel sorry for Nilsson right now, because he is very shortly going to be attacked by Sobolewski if Sobolewski can get close enough. So here we are back to the back to Stenberg. Still pretty much by himself. Look like Ole has been catching him a bit, so these two might be battling for 5th spot with a couple of minutes to go. I believe that's Gary Lennon. Is that Sobolewski spun? I believe it is. So as I said, pushing as hard as he can to try and catch Nilsson and Richard. Oh dear, oh dear, that is a fail. So I think that's dropped him down to... No, that's 12th man. Jordan Weeks has DNF'd. So we have missed that one. So has that put Sobolewski back to 11th? Let's put Tim Brooke to 10th place with 2 minutes 37 to go. So will it be a pole position in race 3 for Tim Brooke? All he needs to do is hold on to it. Don't make any mistakes. And do a Sobolewski. That's going to put Nilsson up to 9th. 8th is Lennon. Oh, Sergio Sousa, sorry. So great performance here from Sergio Sousa. Laid out of the walls. Going to be Wayne Reid in 7th. Gary Lennon in 6th, though. Turned out to be a good recovery from Lennon, who we saw spinning early on in the race. Dropped way down the order. So great performance here by Lennon. 5th. Going to be Foley. So I believe Weeks was obviously up in 4th and crashed. So that's why it's promoted everyone up at one position. So Stenbeck, who also kept out of the wars in this one, is up to 4th. So great performance by Stenbeck. Ericsson has not made any progress since we last saw him. Although the gap was at 1.1 seconds, which is quite a lot in these cars. He's got it down to 8 tenths now. Improving a bit as we've got 1 minute 30 to go. Let's see where Farrow is on track. They will complete this one, so there will be one more to go once the leader pizza slap. Looks like he lost a bit of time to Ruskus last time round, but that's not too much of an issue when you've got a 2 second lead with about a lap and a bit to go. So pretty much all under control again for Farrow. It will be the battle for second, although it doesn't look like Ericsson's going to be close enough as they go on to this last lap. There we are, Matt Farrow crosses the line. Got a bit of traffic in front of them, shouldn't be too much of an issue. Gap is at, up a little bit, so Farrow's still pushing. So Ruskus, second, Ericsson, doesn't look like he's going to be close enough to make a charge for second place. So all falling into the hands of Farrow. Stenbeck is in fourth. Well, he doesn't look close enough either to make a challenge, so he'll be fifth. In sixth is Gary Lennon. But the top six is pretty much sorted. I don't want to be dangerous and say that that'll be it to the flag, because anything can happen, as we've seen on the last lap of the first race. But I'm pretty sure it shouldn't change too much. Seventh place is Wayne Reid. Great forwards by him. Strong top 10 finish. In 8th is Sergio Sousa, another good performance. 9th is Nielsen, so he'll be 2nd if it finishes like this for race 3 grid. And 10th spot, the important spot, is Tim Brooke. So Mr. Unprepared is going to have to prepare himself for a pole position in race 3. And Matt Farrow has crossed the line as we were looking back through. Who's going to be in second? It looks like it was Mr. Ruskus. No, we were right about that. Third was Ericsson. Fourth crosses the line now. Stenbeck, great result for him. Bowley, fifth, good result for him as well. 05 Motorsport driver there. Flash of the lights. Sixth is going to be Gary Lennon. Great recovery. Seventh, Wayne Reid. Followed by Sergio Sousa. Great performance by those two. Ninth is going to be Nielsen. And we see Brooke now. He's going to be on pole position as he weaves a little bit for the cameras. There is Mr. Sobolecki. Oh, he's dropped down even further. So in 11th will be Jonathan Motteram. And Sobolecki 12th. So an awful day at the office for Mr. Sobolecki. As 13th place man. Believe. Let me update that as he ploughs off into turn one. Let me see if I can get that up for you. That was Dave Simmons providing us with some entertainment, and Mario Moraes was in 14th. So we will be back very shortly for race 3. Join us in about 5 minutes.